My name is Dr. Chan. I'm Dean of Admissions here at the University of Utah School of Medicine. Today I'm going to talk to you about Mormon missions, LDS missions, and how you should describe and write about them in your application for medical school. By default, I feel like I'm the expert about this. When I go out to other meetings with other mission deans from other medical schools across the country, this gets brought up a lot. So I'm excited to talk to you more about this. Let's give you some data. Apparently, according to LDS.org, there are 421 missions right now and close to 70,000 missionaries. And why do I feel I can be an expert in this? Guess what? I served a mission. Viva la France. I was out in 96 to 98. I was in Marseille. That's in the south of France. I was in Nice, Cannes, Montpellier, Toulon, Aix-en-Provence, and ça fait bon moment depuis j'ai parlé français avec quelqu'un. All right. So first thing, when you write about your LDS or Mormon mission in your application, avoid language that's too LDS-centric. Everyone knows what FHE is, right? No, everyone doesn't know, okay? So if you use a bunch of acronyms, which are weird and strange, it doesn't look well to mission committees. Avoid judgmental language. When you talk about your mission experience, don't call people disbelievers, heathens, sinners. They're engaging in bad lifestyle. Avoid that language. Don't say that. Don't talk about your mission, don't talk around the mission or be vague about it. We had someone last year wrote that they hung out with people for 2 years. Like, what is that, all right? Describe your mission in a mature, thoughtful way. Call it what it is, okay? Almost all admission committees across the nation do not view proselyting activities as community service. This includes our medical school. We see a very clear line between proselyting activities, knocking on doors, stopping people in the street, versus community service activities. So in my day, we had the White Handbook, the Missionary Handbook, which clearly stated how many community service hours per week does the average missionary perform. And back in my day, it was 4 to 6 hours. And before I came down here to do this presentation, I asked some of our own med students, and it's still around 4 to 6 hours. And those 4 to 6 hours are usually working at a homeless shelter, at a soup kitchen, those things like that, teaching English classes. So when you describe your mission, focus on those community service hours. Don't blend that line between proselyting and community service. Now, when you serve a mission, this in and of itself does not make you unique. We have thousands of people who apply to our med school, medical schools across the country who have served missions. I can say the same for being a district or zone leader, assistant to the president. These type of activities don't make you unique. So the way to conceptualize it is, by the time you apply to med school, even more so with the new change in missionary age requirements, it's 3 to 5 years after the mission, okay? The key question that our mission committee asks is, how have you taken those skills that you've learned on your mission, your community service skills, your leadership skills, your language skills, and how have you applied them after your mission? How have you made the world a better place around you, okay? So people sometimes think that, oh, people who serve missions don't get into our med school. There's somehow some bias built against them. I'm here to tell you that's false. We have many, many, many returned missionaries in our med school. The thing that makes them stand out is they take those skills, they take all those skills they learned on their mission, and they apply them locally, okay? So when you create your application, for example, and you served in Brazil, let's pick on Jack. Jack served in Brazil. And Jack was there about 4 years ago, and Jack clearly documented that he did some really amazing community service in Brazil. He taught English, he worked at a homeless shelter for a while, and he documents that. But looking at his application, for Jack, that was the only community service he did 4 years ago. He is not as strong as Jill, who also served in Brazil many years ago. Also, you know, had the same 4 to 6 hours of community service, teaching English, as well as, you know, volunteering at a homeless shelter. But after Jill got home, she got really, you know, involved in the Portuguese-speaking Brazilian community. She did a bunch of service activities with them. She became involved because that was the first time in Brazil she was exposed to homeless people. So she did a bunch of 4-street clinic stuff here in Salt Lake City. Which Jack or Jill in that example do you think looks better to admission committee members? Jill, because she took those skills and applied them after she got home, whereas Jack, he just put all his community service, all his eggs in the basket of his mission that was 4 years prior. So I hope you enjoyed learning more about LDS missions, how you write about them, how you talk about them in your medical school application, and I look forward to seeing your applications. Thank you.